Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. First, we're going to have a quick look at the previous time frame and the seismic activity that we had from the 31st of December to the 9th, that's yesterday, of January. And we see this typical temporal clustering, as I explained in previous updates. The stronger earthquakes typically with and following the lunar geometry, like here on the 31st of December, and then here on the 3rd, peaking 6.5. And also, most recently, the lunar peaks, semi-right angle geometry, immediately followed by a magnitude 6.5. In Mindanao, Philippines. Again, this temporal clustering, also with the near quintuple conjunction involving Venus and Earth. These are the purple and blue peaks, 5.7 Western Honshu, Japan. Quite some activity around the Philippine sea plate, actually. We see that here, the 6.4, there was this 5.7 in Japan, and also on the east side, down to the Mariana Islands. There was also magnitude 5 activity. In a short time, quite some activity around the Philippine sea plate. And then also 5.3, a sequence of three stronger earthquakes in Tajikistan. The third one in particular was widely felt, magnitude 5.3, and the region is capable of producing stronger earthquakes, something to keep in mind. Then we're going to have a look at the upcoming time frame. This is yesterday. It overlaps with yesterday here on the 9th up until the 18th. And we see three significant peaks, especially yesterday and today. Strong convergence, planetary and lunar geometry, still part of the near quintuple conjunction that we had starting on the 6th. And it goes into the 11th with the last planetary conjunction. And also here, a significant lunar peak on the 14th and also on the 18th. These are the three major peaks in this time frame. I labeled them, and as you can see here, a near quadruple conjunction with Venus, Earth, Mars, and Jupiter. That was yesterday afternoon. And then we have this considerable lunar geometry, right angle geometry with Venus, Mars, Jupiter, and a semi-right angle with Uranus. And there's planetary geometry in there as well. If you look at the solar system, here we see the powerful quadruple conjunction as part of the quintuple conjunction that started on the 6th. Jupiter is in there, Earth is in there, Venus, and also Mars, and the Sun yesterday as well. And look at the lunar geometry. This is significant. We have right angle geometry of Jupiter, and on the opposite side, right angle geometry of Venus and Mars. And in addition, we have the semi-right angle with Uranus. And that combination, that's going to be critical. There can be significant seismic activity as a result of this right angle geometry in an opposite fashion. That's really critical. We can have a seismic event well into the 6th magnitude, maybe even approaching magnitude 7 as a result of this geometry. And that could be later today, tomorrow, I would say around the 11th, give or take one day. And we already see a significant burst of stronger earthquakes following the planetary geometry yesterday. Four stronger earthquakes, 5.5 to 5.7, I think, 5.6. And this is a typical example of temporal clustering of stronger earthquakes that we see in unrelated faults. These are different locations on the planet. Stronger earthquakes don't occur on average. They occur in clusters, temporal clusters in time. This is really significant. And we haven't even entered the lunar geometry here yet. That is still to come today. So I expect this seismic activity to continue, stronger earthquakes into the 11th. And around that time, there could be a stronger earthquake, possibly stronger 6, maybe even magnitude 7, following this peak. Okay, so we see also some notable activity in the Mediterranean, the Ionian Sea, here Italy, a 5.1. We don't see this seismic activity very often in this region. There can be larger earthquakes there. This could be precursor activity, magnitude 6 and even magnitude 7. This has happened here in the past. It's been a while. I think it's been over 100 years since a magnitude 7 occurred near the Calabrian Arc. That is definitely possible. This is something to keep in mind here. And also in Greece, a magnitude 4 earthquake, they occurred in a very short time, and the events were also widely felt. Keep in mind this activity here. Italy has been relatively quiet recently, so this is something to keep in mind. Okay, then we have the next peak here on the 14th. Considerable lunar geometry, semi-right angle with Venus, Mars, Mercury, and Jupiter, and also a planetary conjunction in there, Mercury, Earth-Jupiter, while the Moon was also in a conjunction with Uranus late on the 13th. In the solar system, we see that the quintuple conjunction really is dissolving now. Venus is moving away, Mercury is moving in, but they both move relatively fast. Semi-right angle lunar geometry is noteworthy here with Jupiter, with Mercury, Venus, and also with Mars. And it happens all here on the 14th in a relatively short time. And we can see the typical stronger seismic activity, 5.5 and larger, the temporal clustering at the time and following this geometry. Then finally, on the 18th, we also have significant geometry, a new moon. We have a conjunction with Mercury, Mars, and also with Jupiter. That is lunar-centric, otherwise you would call it an opposition. And in the solar system, we see that now there's no quintuple conjunction here anymore, but we see an opposition here with the Moon and Jupiter. This is significant, and also conjunctions with Mercury and with Mars. And as a result, there can be stronger seismic activity coming up following this geometry, I'd say around the 19th, give or take one day. And also, we don't see the geometry with Saturn and Neptune so much in with these peaks, but in between we see symmetrically small lunar peaks right there on the 12th and on the 16th, and you will see Saturn in there. This is semi-right, 135 degrees, and also Neptune, 135 degrees. And as you can see, if we divide the semi-right angle like 45 by 2, we get 22.5 degrees. These are sublunar geometry angles like 67.5 degrees and also 112.5 degrees. And if we look at the 16th, we see 22.5 degrees and also 157.5 degrees. These are all the sublunar geometries. These are subharmonics of the electromagnetic wave. They could have some influence. I don't consider them very strong, but we can see the beautiful symmetry in the solar system right now with the major geometry, the high peaks, and right pretty much in between we have this subgeometry as well. This beautiful symmetry in the solar system with the quintuple conjunction is noteworthy. Okay, so today we have this considerable geometry in the solar system, planetary and lunar geometry, and there can be an obvious seismic response, the typical temporal clustering of stronger earthquakes, and also there could be a 6 or a magnitude 7 following this geometry. Okay, this is the update for now. Stay safe, everyone. Check out the updates on the website and the social media. Be safe, everyone, and until next time.